Welcome back to the channel, everybody. My name's Artie with CoinCasso, and this is Bitcoin Today, a show where we talk about everything cryptocurrency to keep you guys up to date and informed on all things happening in the crypto industry. In today's episode, Ethereum addresses in profit have soared 132% in the last year, and statistics show Ethereum is the best performing asset class in 2020. We're also going to do a deep dive technical analysis on Ethereum, as well as the top cryptocurrency prices today. So if you haven't noticed, the whole episode is on Ethereum. Good morning, everybody. It is Friday, July 31st. Thank you so much for joining me every single day. Really, like, I cannot believe the growth and expansion of this channel over the last 30 days. You guys, the new subscribers, all the likes, all the comments, like, I'm absolutely blown away. And if you're new here and you like what you see in this video, consider subscribing down below, tick the notification bell to get notified every time we upload a new one, and share the video with your friends if you want. I just want to say I appreciate you guys so much. And as always, the show is sponsored by the CoinCasso Cryptocurrency Exchange, the official partner of Paris Saint-Germain. So if you're looking for a place to buy, sell, and trade cryptocurrencies, check out CoinCasso in the link in the description below. All right, let's jump into these prices. Bitcoin currently sitting at $11,058, up 0.3% from yesterday. Ethereum doing astronomically well, as always, $333, up 5% from yesterday. Chainlink finally down out of its slump, up 8.28% from yesterday at $7.74. Cardano still down 0.5% at 0.1401. And Litecoin seems to continue to rally at $56.54, up 3.2% from yesterday. Taking a look at the 24-hour volume on CoinMarketCap, Bitcoin currently sitting at 22.2 billion in the last 24 hours, Ethereum 11.6 billion, XRP 1.5 billion, Cardano really low at 239 million, and Chainlink 665 million. Wow, Litecoin almost 3 billion. Now let's jump into TradingView and do a deep dive into Ethereum. Okay, so what I have here is the 1 day chart of Ethereum since the March 12th bottom, which reached a low of $89.36. Since then, we've been on a nice, slow, steady climb with a long flat line here of the most boring time in cryptocurrency ever. And then 11 days ago, we started to climb up like crazy. Currently from the March 12th bottom, taking a look at this entire thing, if you were to invest $1,000 at the very, very bottom, you would be up 286% in profit, meaning that you'd have $3,860. That's just a fantastic return on investment. Now, looking at this latest rally, we've been doing very, very well in the positive green candlestick almost every single day. We did see a large pullback right here, but that's just because it hit its previous highest high. So there was a lot of sell orders here pushing the price back down, but the bulls control the market right now and they keep pushing it up. As you can see here on the RSI, usually when it's above the 70 level, that means the market is overbought and we usually see a come down, but it's been rallying up above. The cool thing about the RSI is when it gets and stays above the 82 level, that's when we see massive, massive parabolic growth, and parabolic just straight up, like rocket ships. So let me draw a horizontal line across the 82 level and see when the last time it did this type of price action. So we have here on February 11th, 2020, above the 82 level, and we saw literally parabolic growth. Again, May 2017, parabolic growth. Three times here in 2017, parabolic, 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 reaching its maximum price of $1,400. Now, I want you guys to understand that this little spike right here was 12 days, and it shot from $600 to $1,400. So I'm not going to predict what I think Ethereum is going to do over the next week because it's seriously nonsense. I'm expecting massive growth, massive jumps up in price, and parabolic straight green candlesticks. I honestly think this is a horrible time to like take your profits in Ethereum because you need the money. If you keep it here, Ethereum is the fastest growing and most used cryptocurrency. Every functional thing that works on blockchain or with crypto uses Ethereum. 90% of the altcoins, Ethereum. dapps, DeFi protocols, Ethereum. There's articles online right now because it's Ethereum's fifth birthday. They showed their entire plan over 5 years and were exactly where they wanted to be. Ethereum will hit that $1,400 mark again. And just to quickly talk about last night's move, because I watched it, I was just sitting on my phone like, oh my God, Ethereum's going up again. And then I know every single time we have these parabolic spikes, we always have a correction of people taking their profits, taking that spike up and then going down about 50% of that gain. And as you can see right here, over the last 10 hours, we've seen that parabolic spike up and then a drop of 50%. Don't try to anticipate these because you'd never know when they're gonna happen. Just buy and hold. And these little things won't even matter to you when you look at daily candlestick charts or weekly and you just see green all the way up. But it is pretty cool that Ethereum hit $342 last night. I was watching it live and it was like the most interesting thing in the world to me. Now, on to the news. Ethereum addresses in profit have soared 132% in a year. Even with Ethereum close to yearly highs, profitable addresses have been grown by a hefty 132% since last July. While the second largest cryptocurrency is trading with only relatively small price increases year on year, the number of profit-making or in-the-money addresses has more than doubled to 31.37 million, up from 13.5 million over that time. The numbers indicate many took advantage of the opportunity to buy Ether under $300, resulting in almost 18 million more in profit addresses, a rise of 132%. The majority of the buying may have happened following the cryptocurrency's dip to levels near $100 in December 2019 and March 2020. So very rarely are there people that you know that bought Ethereum when it was at $1,200 and are still holding on to it. Most Ethereum addresses have happened recently, and these people all bought since March, because in March, everybody was talking about crypto. A lot of people came into the crypto space and a lot of people bought into Ethereum and Bitcoin. So congratulations for all of you that hold Ethereum that are in the profit. And on to the next article of the day, Ethereum is the best performing asset class of 2020. The average performance across Ethereum-based assets has been a nearly 130% year-to-date gain. The data provides an oversight of 178 assets that currently exist on Ethereum, totaling a combined market capitalization of $63.7 billion, just shy of 20% of the entire crypto capitalization. Including stablecoins, 124 of the assets have posted a year-to-date gain, meaning that 70% of the Ethereum-based tokens have increased in value despite the shock felt across the entire global economy amid the pandemic. Excluding Tether, only Ether and Crypto.com sit among the top 10 crypto assets by market cap, closely followed by the 12th-ranked Chainlink. One-third of the Ethereum-based markets have more than doubled in value since the start of the year, with Ether ranking as the 41st strongest performing asset with year-to-date gains of 142%. Everything that Ethereum touches right now turns to gold. Even the name ERC20 tokens, like people know that's Ethereum and they're like, oh, I trust that. I'm very, very, very bullish on Ethereum. You can ask anybody that I speak to. I'm daily pushing Ethereum. I think it's the number one cryptocurrency and has the most potential for profitability and growth and expanding the cryptocurrency industry. A lot of people don't want to get into crypto because they see the market volatility and they don't want to invest, but a lot of people use these dapps and these DeFi protocols all built on Ethereum, building up the crypto industry and getting more users into the space. Some people jump headfirst into crypto, invest a ton of money, and they're all about it. A lot of people, the majority, actually need to slowly test the waters, and dapps and DeFi protocols based on Ethereum is going to be the way to do that. Now, why do I keep saying Ethereum is number one when it is sitting at the number two spot on CoinMarketCap? Ethereum's current circulating supply is 111 million Ether. With the current price of $332, that gives it a market capitalization of $37.2 billion, while Bitcoin is sitting at $203 billion. So what would Ethereum have to do to jump up to the number one spot? Currently, it would have to get up to $1,821, giving it a market capitalization of $204 billion. With its previous highest high at $1,400 and the fact that back then, cryptocurrency was very, very young and very few people used it. Now, it's very widely adopted. It's one of the most solid platforms, and everybody trusts it so much that they build on it. I think this is the beginning of the next bull run, and we should break through that $1,400 barrier, and I don't see why we couldn't get to $1,800. Bringing it up to the number one spot on CoinMarketCap, which everybody's been calling the flippening, where Ethereum and Bitcoin flip positions. I'd like to know from you guys, what do you think? Is it possible for Ethereum to break into the number one spot on CoinMarketCap or no? Leave your answer in the comment section down below. Thank you so much for watching today, and we will see you back here on Monday. So have a great weekend.